തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് അടവ് നയം പിന്നീട് തീരുമാനിക്കുമെന്ന് സീതാറാം യെച്ചൂരി ഏഷ്യാനെറ്റ് ന്യൂസിനോട് പറഞ്ഞു. കേരള ഘടകവുമായി ഭിന്നതയില്ല, കേരള ഘടകമാണ് എല്ലാം നിയന്ത്രിക്കുന്നതെന്ന വാദം തെറ്റാണെന്നും പാർട്ടിയിലെ എല്ലാ ഘടകങ്ങൾക്കും ഒരേ പ്രാധാന്യമാണെന്നും യെച്ചൂരി കൂട്ടിച്ചേർത്തു.
CPM ജനറൽ സെക്രട്ടറിയായി വീണ്ടും തിരഞ്ഞെടുക്കപ്പെട്ട സീതാറാം യെച്ചൂരി ഇപ്പോൾ നമ്മളോടൊപ്പം ചേരുകയാണ്. ശ്രീ സീതാറാം യെച്ചൂരി, കൺഗ്രാജുലേഷൻസ് ആൻഡ് ബെസ്റ്റ് വിഷസ് ഫോർ ഗെറ്റിംഗ് റീ ഇലക്റ്റഡ് ആസ് ദി CPM ജനറൽ സെക്രട്ടറി. In the speech you said that there should be unity in the party, but still people thought that there is a difference inside the party. Has Sitaram actually emerged big after this party conference?
You see, unity inside the party is something we always emphasize. Comrade Ho Chi Minh taught us that the unity of the party must be guarded like the apple of the eye. That is our internal strength. That is our biggest weapon. And if the party is united and determined, like we have emerged from this Congress, then we will definitely make many big strides in the future.
Were you able to put forward your political line in the party Congress? Has the party Congress agreed to your political line?
No, you see, there is no my political line or somebody else's political line. Party Congress is now a political line. And that political line is in black and white. It is not a line that can be interpreted by anybody. It is very clearly written down, a black and white line. And that was on the basis of an amendment moved by the steering committee. That was accepted by the Congress. And on that basis, the political line of the party was defined and unity on that political line has been established.
In that political line, is there a space for 2004 model cooperation with the secular forces?
You see, the political line clearly defines that there is no political alliance with the Congress. And if you remember our own history, the CPIM has never entered into any political alliance with the Congress party or any big bourgeois landlord party, which we call the ruling class parties. What we had in 1996 was outside support. 2004 was outside support. Never a political alliance. So depending on the concrete situation, we will take our appropriate electoral tactics. What we said in our political resolution, which is now adopted, appropriate electoral tactics to maximize the pooling of anti-BJP vote based on this political line. That is the is very clear cut.
There was always a criticism inside the party that the Kerala unities doing everything inside the party, they have a bigger hand, etc. After the formation of the new Politburo and the Central Committee, is there a balance?
Well, number one, that allegation was never correct. There is no, you know, one group versus another group in our party. It's not Bengal versus Kerala. That is your democratic right as the media to create, which you are doing it. But as far as we are concerned, we are CPIM. There are no groups in between. Now, the new committees that have been elected reflect the relative strength of our party all over the country. And in that sense, these are cohesive bodies that are now entrusted with the very important task of carrying forward the people's struggles, intensifying them to give a policy alternative to the existing challenges that are being posed before us by the current RSS-BJP government. So, ousting this government is our priority.
Last question. You retained Comrade V.S. Sachidanandan in the Central Committee as a special invitee. So, were you instrumental in that?
Why? The whole committee, Comrade V.S. Sachidanandan, is a towering figure of our revolutionary movement in India. He was one of the founders of our party, of the communist movement in Kerala. And if you recollect, at the beginning of the Congress, in the inaugural session itself, we had honored two of our veteran comrades. One was Comrade V.S. Sachidanandan, the other was Comrade N. Shankaraya. These are the only two surviving members of the 32 who walked out to the CPI National Council then. And they were, both of them were the members of the first Central Committee elected after CPIM was formed in 1964. So V.S. has got that legacy.
And you gave exemption to Mr. S. Ramendran Pillai on the age factor. Why it was?
That was because, you see, for the party center functioning, Comrade Ramachandra Pillai has been functioning and working with us for the last 3 decades. I mean, in fact, Comrade Ramachandra Pillai, Comrade Prakash and myself, along with 2 comrades who are no longer there, we all came into the Central Secretariat of the party simultaneously in 1988, and today it's 2018. So for 30 years, Comrade SRP, as we call him, was part of the core of the party center, which of that, as I told you, Prakash and I and he, they formed the basic core from that period. So we thought that his presence is required, I mean, to run the party center. And therefore, we know his age, we know, I mean, we sympathize with the burdens that are there with him. I mean, therefore it was decided not to put any additional, what you call, responsibilities or demands on his right? But his contribution and availability to make the partition center functional in a better way, that will be important. Therefore, the exemption was granted.
So I am concluding this. So, you are hopeful that you can take along the Kerala unit also with you, because the 2021 Kerala election will be coming under you now, and 2019 Lok Sabha elections will be also under you.
I am confident of not only taking the Kerala unit along, I am confident taking the whole party along, taking all the units along. And that is what our party is. There is no this unit versus another unit. So we will all be there together, united and determined.
Thank you very much. എന്തായാലും എല്ലാ ഘടകങ്ങളെയും ഒരുപോലെ കൊണ്ടുപോകാനും പാർട്ടിയിലെ ഐക്യം നിലനിർത്താനും തനിക്ക് കഴിയുമെന്നുള്ള പ്രതീക്ഷയാണ് സീതാറാം യെച്ചൂരി പ്രകടിപ്പിക്കുന്നത്.